Welcome to the Lightspeed Restaurant Getting Started video guide for K-Series. I'm Vinny, and in this video, we're going to show you how to process orders using table service. There's two sales modes in Lightspeed Restaurant, direct sales and table service. Direct sales is perfect for counter service and takeaway. Table service is designed for establishments that use seating and coursing. For more information on direct sales and table service modes, check the link to the Help Center article in the description below. If you require seating, coursing, or you'd like to split checks during payment, you'll have to use table service. There's two ways to switch to table service. Either give the order a name or assign the order to a table. We'll cover both methods in this video. Regardless of which mode you choose, before you can take orders, you'll need to have clocked in for the day, an open sales period, and logged in. For more information about these topics, see our Help Center and other Getting Started videos. You'll find links below in the description. Now let's get ordering. To begin, let's give an order a name. This holds the order open for future changes. After you've logged in, hit the Tab Name button on the register screen. Enter a name for the order, for example, Sam Green or Bluth Party. Remember, the order name you enter here will be printed on the guest's check, so choose wisely. To confirm, tap OK. You'll see the assigned name appear in the top left corner. Next, we'll assign the order to a table. Assigning an order to a table switches the register to table service. You can assign a table either from the register or the floor plan screen. From the floor plan screen, tap on a table to select it. The order is now assigned to that table. Orders are assigned the default number of covers for the table you've selected. To change the number of covers, tap the knife and fork icon. Then, enter the number of covers. From the register screen, the quickest way you can assign a table is by entering a number with the keypad and then tapping the Tables button. Be careful when assigning tables this way, since you can enter any number, even if that table number has not been set up in the back office. To change which table the order is assigned to, enter the new table number and tap Switch Table. The order is now assigned to the new table. If you've accidentally started an order in table service and need to return to direct sales, you'll have to start over with a new order by tapping the clear button on the keypad. If a confirmation appears, tap yes. The register switches back to direct sales and any in-progress orders will be canceled. Once your order is set up in table service, you're ready to start adding items to the order, by course or by seat. When you start an order in table service, by default, the register sets your view to by course and creates the first course. To add more courses, tap Add a Course. To add items to a course, first, select the course in the item list to highlight it. Then, tap an item button to add it to that course for the table. When adding an item by course, you can specify a seat for it. Above the item buttons, tap the plus button to add the number of seats you need. Then, select a seat number and tap the item to add it. You'll see the item is added to the chosen course and seat. When viewing by course, the item list is grouped into courses, and each ordered item shows whether it's for a specific seat or a shared item. You can also add items by seat. Switch at any time by tapping by course to open the drop-down menu and then tapping by seat. The items list updates to show shared items and items per seat. Coursing information for each item is shown in the item details section. The keypad disappears, and the seat selector changes to the course selector. Similarly to adding items by course, we can add items while viewing by seat. Tap the desired seat from the item list, then above the item buttons, select a course, and finally tap an item button to add it. Once items have been added to your order, you can edit items in three ways. Edit individual items, edit multiple items, or edit all items at once. To change individual items, tap the pencil icon next to the item's name. On the menu that appears, you can change the item's quantity, transfer it to another seat, or transfer it to another course. To edit multiple items together, first tap Edit Order. Select each item you wish to change. Then, select the action you wish to perform on them and complete any additional steps. Tap Done to apply your changes. You can also edit all of the ordered items on a single course or seat by tapping the pencil icon next to it. To edit the entire order at once, tap Actions. In the Actions menu, you can change the order name, clear all unsent items, refund all items, apply a discount, or select an order profile. Once the order is entered, you can send the items to the kitchen or prep station by tapping Send. After an order is sent, you cannot change which course or seat the items are assigned to. If your order contains just one course, the entire order will be prepared all at once. If your order contains multiple courses, the station will see the entire order divided by course. For orders with multiple courses, you can notify the station to start preparing subsequent courses by navigating back to the order and tapping Fire Course. Before we move on, let's quickly go through an in-progress order. Courses with an orange flame icon are in progress. They have already been sent to the kitchen. Courses with a green checkmark are completed. As you fire each course, the orange flame icon moves down to mark the last fired course. Upcoming courses have no icon and can be fired in sequence. And what if your guests add extra items after your order has already been sent? With your order open, add the new items to their respective courses as we previously showed you. Once you're ready, tap Send. This will print a ticket in the kitchen with only the added items. When your guests are ready to go, open the order from the Orders screen. Next to the order's name, tap Actions. Then, tap the Print Receipt button. Once they are ready to pay for their order, open the order and tap Pay at the bottom of the screen. Select a payment method, then confirm the amount. If tips are enabled, select the tip amount. Finally, tap Pay to complete the order. And that's how to manage orders and table service. For more information, you can continue with our Getting Started video series or visit the articles in our Help Center. If you have any questions, check out any of the links in the description below.